Okay, everybody, how about that? We started today with Big Time. And the reason we started with Big Time by Peter Gabriel was because we're going to talk about a fundamental today that is big time important. And it really is important as professionals and in our personal life. And I'm joined, I'm joined by one of our superstars, Miss Kristi Kulis. Who just helps us do great things. And those of you who have worked with Kristi, which I know is many of you, you know how special she is and what a great job she does. But she's here to talk with us today about honoring commitments. So when I thought about this fundamental and who came to mind, she may have been at the top of the list. So Kristi, tell me, when you hear, well, first of all, thanks for being here.
You're welcome.
And when you hear honor commitments, what comes to mind to you?
About somebody doing what they say they're going to do. So when you tell somebody you're going to do something, you have to make sure you follow through with that. And if you can't honor that time, then give them notice an explanation of why you can't do that. Don't wait until after the time and say, I'm sorry, I'm not going to make it. Because it's not right.
Yeah, so great point you just made. Because sometimes things happen in life that we don't predict, and so we've got a commitment that we've made, and sometimes we may have circumstances that come up that make it tough to honor that commitment. Mm-hmm. So one of the things you said, we said two things very important. If you tell somebody you're going to do something, do it.
Yep.
But number two, when things do come up, as soon as you can, let your teammate, your client, your friend, your mm-hmm. family member, that you've got some challenges, you're not going to be able to honor that commitment, mm-hmm. and then work together in the spirit of win-win mm-hmm. to come up with a new time. Mm-hmm. So great comments. So as we talk about this fundamental of honor commitments, you know, sometimes when people don't honor commitments, it really impacts us.
Yes.
And I'm going to play a song real quick about how I think it impacts us, and then I want you to comment on it. I think you've got a story to tell us.
I do.
So, Kristi, we talked earlier about a story you had, mm-hmm. and you know, I think one thing that we don't realize is when we don't honor commitments, or somebody doesn't honor the commitment they made to us, mm-hmm. it brings us down, mm-hmm. causes
yes,
frustration,
it
challenges. Talk about, you had a story and yeah. how it made you feel and how it brought you down.
So recently, I've gone through a house remodel, and everyone knows that when somebody tells you they're going to be there to, and you've got to wait during that time frame, and they don't show up and they don't honor their commitment, it's frustrating because you've wasted a few hours of your day, or you've put something off that you wanted to get done because that person said they were coming and then they don't come, or they don't email you or text you that they ran into an issue until 3 hours after the time they said they were going to be there. It's really frustrating. And it goes the same way in our office, that if an employee says, I need you to call me by 4 because I'm on break by 4 and I can't be on the phone, and we miss that window, that's frustrating for them. And so we have to make sure we honor our commitments. If we tell somebody we're going to call them back by 6, we need to call them back by 6, because if we don't call, they're thinking we're not taking care of their issue.
Yeah. And what when as teammates we maybe fall short honoring commitments, mm-hmm. How does it impact us? Not just how we feel, but in the way it maybe gets in the way of us being at our best.
Mm-hmm. Like if we are working on a project and we tell a client that we'll have something to them by a certain time frame, and you're waiting on everyone to complete their part, and one person doesn't do it, it makes the whole team miss that deadline, and it doesn't make us look good to a client.
right? Or to each other. And, you know,
it makes us look unorganized.
Yeah. And many times sometimes it's not even intentional, but I just think it's something we've really got to focus on. And, you know, it's hard work, but it is a difference maker in business today.
Yeah.
You know, you're regarded, Kristi, as somebody in the organization. I told you earlier when I thought about this fundamental, you came to mind quickly. So you're regarded, I think, throughout the organization, even in OneDigital. You won a special award last year for your work. Why is this important to you? Why are you so good? What is it that causes you to excel as somebody who honors commitments, and you build such a great reputation around that?
So I can't tell you how I do it. I just do it. I think it's kind of ingrained in me. It's customer service that I learned my first job when I was 16 at Burger King and things like that. But I believe in the golden rule. And I think that I want others to treat me the way I want to treat them and do unto others that they would have do unto you. So if I know that if I want to be treated with respect, I need to give respect and I need to honor my commitment, and that person's going to feel like I've got their back. And whether it's a client, an employee, or a teammate, I want my teammates to know I've got your back. And the only way to do it is to honor the commitment.
Well, you know, you do it well. I appreciate so much you taking the time to share your thoughts today, mm-hmm. because they're, once again, your reputation speaks for itself. So words from you mean a lot.
Thank you.
But when we honor commitments, it made me think of a song that we're going to play to end us out. And I think we've all heard it. It's an oldie but a goodie. But we like it when people honor commitments,
yes.
correct?
Mm-hmm. It makes you feel good.
Yeah. So let's play a song as we take it out and head everybody into hopefully a great week and working towards honoring commitments.
Okay.
All right. Thanks, Kristi.
You're welcome.
All right. So there you go, guys. Honor commitments. That's the way we like it. So once again, Miss Kristi Kulis, helping us be better, sharing her thoughts, and everybody have a great week. Take care.